I think we're all worried about Jesse. Throwing up when you have so little hydration to go around is bad. It's bad for her, it's bad for us.
The hardest thing I would have to say is really, I'm unaccustomed to such physical drain. You know, I'm unaccustomed to having to work for my food, you know, work for my water. Very unaccustomed to it. And that's been hard.
Tremel said that we have our disgusting food challenge today, and there's nothing I won't eat. You know, it could be beef brain, goat, testicles, whatever. Sounds good. Breakfast.
I just feel like a big loser, you know. I couldn't chug beer in college, and I can't chug blood out here. I just, you know, I tried my hardest. I wasn't grossed out by it. I didn't think it tasted bad. I thought for sure it was in the bag. You know, between Kim tripping in the last reward challenge and me failing to perform on my challenge today, it's, you know, it's anybody's game.
If our team is just real losers and we lose everything, that's gonna be awful. We've worked really hard and suffered a lot with no food and no water and stuff like that, and just to see people out here who just don't take it seriously and be stuck with them, it's painful. This is no Zamboura trap. I'm not on the Zamboura trap. The red, it's a red herring. It's a false front. I am still on Baron, and so is Lex, and so is Tom. We have to anticipate going to tribal council because we are outmanned so drastically. If this challenge is in any way physical, I don't see the point in playing. We will lose.
But I think we will lose today.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Why?
Because they have Silas and Clarence and Ethan.
Oh, man.
The good part about it is that me, Lex, and Tom have no votes against us.
Good morning.
How are you?
So, no matter who they pick, we should be okay as long as we pick the one of them that has votes against them. Tom and I and Lex have all sort of whispered our own little bit. They talk too loud, though, too. You gotta watch, because the eavesdropping, of course, goes both ways.
Whoa, bird sky.
But, we all like Brandon the best. Well, I mean, that's not true. I like Kim a lot, too. But Kim's just so much more of a physical threat. And then Lindsay, everyone thinks is really annoying. People just want to see what's shaken up at Baran, because what goes on over there could totally affect what happens over here. Luckily, we were all able to hold it down. We were all very proud of ourselves. And having all this energy stored up should definitely give us an edge, I hope. I'm such an idiot. All this time, Kim at the challenges, she was doing this. And I'm like, what does this mean, lose? Do you want me to throw the challenge? What's the L? The L? And then I'm sitting there, and I'm like, oh, Lindsay. Obviously, she thinks Lindsay has votes against her. And also, I think she was trying to tell me Brandon. Because she was doing something like this. I don't know. I think it's B in sign language. She knows sign language. I don't know it. Lex is so politicking for a win, and that's fine. But just watching him make screens for Tom and kiss ass to everybody and talk in his dad voice annoys me.
Uber.
Oh, my God.
It's got a brand name.
Am I the only one who notices he's a totally weird person? It's annoying. I would like to vote off Lex in a perfect world. If I thought there was going to be no merger ever, then I would do it in a heartbeat. Frank is a very big loner. He socially seems so inept. I mean, I guess probably a large section of the population is introverted and antisocial, and that's fine, but I feel like there are prescription drugs to counteract that, and he should maybe be on them. We play this game, I Never, which is like, you're supposed to like tell dirty stories and whatever. It's Moto Magi, Moto Magi, Momo Magi, I don't know. Today, Lex came up with this scheme. Lex, the Grandmaster Lex, that for some reason people bow to. I don't understand why. Oh, and as if that's more ethical, because Lex is like, well, I can't boldface lie to him. Okay, you can just lie to him all day when it would be inconvenient to tell him the truth. But then the last possible moment, you'll slip in the truth, and that's gonna make you an ethical person.
Okay. Thanks, man.
I like Clarence. The kid has really grown on me. I mean, he sensed that people were getting rubbed the wrong way by him, and he changed his ways. I like him. I think he's friendly. I think he's funny. He's part of the group, unlike crazy outcast Frank. This morning, Lex was just a total jerk. I mean, what do you expect in this game? I mean, I'm sorry. Someone voted against you, Mr. Ego. Deal with it.
It was not me.
I swear on your brother?
I swear on my brother. I swear on my brother's name. I swear on both my parents. I really would. I'll look you in the eye.
You are?
I am. I promise you.
Okay, well, it really wasn't me, but screw you, Lex, if you're gonna sit here and yell at me like you're my dad, and I'm 5, and I just stole cookies for something I didn't do. Kim, she kind of asked me to vote with them, and I said no, I have to vote with my tribe, but, you know, best of luck with your little coup, and we'll see what happens. Ever ever since the immunity challenge, things have been very different. Different than they've ever been before. Lex hasn't been laying down the orders of who I'm supposed to vote for, who we're supposed to vote for, so I have no clue really what's going on. My butt is on the line because, you know, my own teammates are all trying to turn against me, and I'm just like, this is ridiculous. I feel like my only real strategy is to try to defect and team up with the four from Samburu.
I love you, Mom and Dad. I can't help but be myself. And I've never been too good at sticking to one quick. I always kind of float around. It was hard for me not to have friends in different places, and that kind of screwed me. But hey, I made it past the hard part with the boulders and whatnot. And for a skinny girl, that's kind of, you know, it's a big deal. I had a lot of fun.